there is nothing difficult in English. Again, I would like to say, the only difficult thing is your wrong way of learning. Don't let perfection paralyze you. Some people, what they do, they feel that, yeah, if I will be perfect, then I will do it. Perfection will come when you will start doing something. But if I have to choose one thing, which is very important for every learner, that is self-belief. If you do not believe in yourself, you cannot do anything, right? If you do not have belief, even the easiest thing will be difficult for you. But if you believe in yourself, even the toughest thing will be easy for you. See, grammar doesn't matter as much as you think it does. Okay, before I answer this question, I would like to ask you, do you know Hindi language?
Yes.
Okay, can you speak Hindi? I can say easily, if I don't want to come with you, I can say, I can't come with you in British. But in American, I have to say, I can come with you. My friends, you will learn more from failure than success, right? So just learn from your failure and keep moving forward in your life.
Hi everyone, welcome back to our YouTube channel. This is Momin Sharfia. And today we have with us our mentor, counselor, trainer, one of the best influential personalities in our city, who has been teaching from the past 11 years, who is the founder of SS English Academy. Through his academy, has helped many students, teachers, advocates to speak English fluently by his very simple but effective techniques. And in this video, he's gonna help you to make your English perfect too. So do watch this informative and interesting video till the end.
First of all, thank you so much, sir, for giving me this fantastic opportunity to take your interview.
Well, it's my pleasure.
How are you, sir?
Yes, I'm great.
As you know, sir, English is very important nowadays. It's very important to learn English. It's very important to speak it. So the first question I would like to ask you, that what is the first step for start learning English?
There's so many learners, they want to learn English language because it is very important and it is a need of an hour, right? So what is the most common mistake? There are so many people, they start learning from advanced level. So you have to start from basic. As you ask that, what is the first step to learning English? First step is definitely listening. You have to start listening. Right? Some people want to be expert in English in just a couple of days. Right? So it is not possible. You cannot be expert in anything overnight. Right? So you have to start listening English videos, listening English stories. Then after, you can jump at advanced level. Some people also commit this mistake, they start learning from grammar and then they get confused and they stop learning English language. Right? So the first step to learn English is start from basic, start listening English stories, which will help you a lot to improve your English language.
Most of the students start learning English through grammar. So it is important to learn completely grammar for learning English.
Okay, it's a very good question. There are so many people, they want to learn English with grammar. Some people feel that grammar is the heart of language. Yes, I do agree, grammar is the heart of language. But for learning English language, you don't need to learn complete grammar. Right? So some people, what they do, they start learning grammar, they get confused and they stop learning English. Because when you get confused, then you feel that it is very difficult. Then after, you stop learning it. Right? So learn grammar, but only basics, like tenses you can learn. Then modal auxiliary verbs, where you have to use can, where you have to use could, then may and might, what is the difference, right? So you have to learn basic grammar. For learning English, for speaking English, you don't need to learn complete grammar. Yes, if you are going for SSC exam, if you are going for HSC exam, then grammar is important, then you need to learn. But if you are going to learn English language, you have to learn just the basics of grammar. But some people, what they do, they feel that when I will be perfect in English, then I will start speaking English language. They don't want to commit any mistake, right? So I would like to recommend all the viewers that don't let perfection paralyze you. Some people, what they do, they feel that, yeah, if I will be perfect, then I will do it. Perfection will come when you will start doing something, right? So just start learning from basic grammar, learn basic grammar, and just keep speaking English language. Don't worry about mistakes.
Most of the LMS ask this question, that how long it takes to learn English. So according to you, how much time do we need to learn English fluently?
Yeah, it is a very common question. See, learning a language is a lifetime project. Some people want to learn in a couple of days or a couple of months. So you cannot learn English just in a couple of days, right? So it takes time and you have to keep some patience. Like if you join in English speaking classes, if you join any course, then you want to learn English in just 7 days or 1 month, 2 months. It is not possible, right? Even I would also say that I'm still learning, right? So if you talk about language, so you can learn a lot of things, right? So if somebody will ask me like how long it takes to learn English, I would say that at least 4 months with full dedication and hard work. Even these 4 months will not work if you're not doing hard work, right? So you have to continuously do practice. If you do 1 hour practice every day, then at least you need 4 months to make your English fluent.
Is learning English difficult?
Okay, before I answer this question, I would like to ask you, do you know Hindi language?
Yes.
Okay, can you speak Hindi?
Yes, I can speak English.
Hindi.
Yes, I can speak Hindi very fluently because it's my mother tongue.
It's your mother tongue. See, we can speak Hindi fluently, right? That's why we feel that Hindi is simple language. That's why I feel that Urdu is easier than English. Do you know there are more than 52 letters in Hindi? But if you talk about English language, so there are only 26 letters. And these 26 letters make this language very easy. Right, A to Z, the complete English is in this only. Right? So you have to, first of all, you have to make up your mind that English is very easy language. I'm not telling you this because I know English language. Some people say that, oh sir, you know English, that's why you're saying that English is easy. No, I have experienced it. In my learning process, I experienced that English is very easy language. You can learn it very easily. I would like to give you one more example. I just want to talk about foreigners. Foreigners can't speak Hindi language, right? But there are so many Indians, they speak very good English. Even some Indians can speak English like foreigners. But foreigners can't speak Hindi. Why? Because Hindi is difficult. Hindi is more difficult than English. Right? So just keep one thing in your mind that English is the easiest language to learn. It is the easiest language to learn. Just you need to learn with positive attitude.
Well, most of the people don't get confident while speaking. So how to get confident while speaking? I mean, how to speak English confidently?
Okay, yes. I really believe that confidence is the most important part of our life, and especially when you're going to learn something, then confidence is very important for you. And confidence is the half victory, right? If you have confidence, then you can win the 50% game easily, right? So confidence plays a very important role. Now, how can you get the confidence when you try to speak English language? So see, confidence will come when you will start speaking English language. If you want to get confidence, you will have to take some steps. You will have to start speaking, means force yourself to speak English language. Some people don't speak English language. They don't force themselves. They feel that, okay, when I will get perfect, then I will start speaking English language. Then when you will get confidence, whatever English you know, just speak. Don't worry about your mistakes. See, I have seen so many learners, they have confidence. Their English is not good, but they have a lot of confidence. But that's why they speak English language. But on the other hand, I have seen a lot of learners, they can speak very good English, but they do not have confidence. That's why they do not speak English, right? So if you have confidence, even you will speak wrong English, but you will speak. So confidence plays a very important role if you want to learn something, and especially if you're going to learn a language. So learning a language is a gradual process. It takes time. So your confidence will help you a lot in learning English language, right? So you will get confidence when you start speaking. Speak in front of mirror, speak in an empty room. These activities will give you a lot of confidence to speak English language. And learn from your mistakes, right? Some people, when they commit mistake, they lose their confidence. My friends, you will learn more from failure than success, right? So just learn from your failure and keep moving forward in your life.
Most of the learners get confused between British or American English. So is there any difference between British or American English?
Yeah, actually some people have misconception. They feel that there are two English. One is British, one is American. They are not two English, there are two kinds of English. British English or American English. Now I would like to tell you there are three major differences. The first one is spelling difference. You would have seen somewhere like center, C-E-N-T-R-E or C-E-N-T-E-R. So in British, you write C-E-N-T-R-E. In American, you write C-E-N-T-E-R. Now, if you don't know the difference between British and American, then you will say that, okay, C-E-N-T-E-R, it is correct, and C-E-N-T-R, it is wrong. It happens sometimes. Like color, spelling of color. one day I asked my students, like, what is the correct spelling of color? C-O-L-O-U-R or C-O-L-O-R? Students said that C-O-L-O-U-R is correct and C-O-L-O-R is incorrect. Both are correct, right? C-O-L-O-U-R you write in British and C-O-L-O-R you write in American, right? So this is the first difference, spelling difference. Second difference is grammar difference. Like if I have to say I have one brother and one sister, this is in British, but in American they use got. I got one brother and one sister. I got a new bike. Like this, they use like this, right? And if you talk about collective nouns, like India, army, so in British English, we have to use are, like India are. But in American English, they use is with collective noun, India is, right? Then there is one more difference. American people use simple past tense and British people use present perfect most of the time. So this is the second difference, which is grammar difference. Third one, which is very important one, which I like most about American English, pronunciation. If I talk about British English, they have like simple pronunciation, easy to pronounce. But in American, like you have to learn it. You would have listened the name American accent, right? So in British, I can say easily, if I don't want to come with you, I can say I can't come with you in British. But in American, I have to say I can come with you, right? In American English, after N, they don't pronounce, after N if there is T, so then they don't pronounce this T. Like they don't say international, they say international, internet, 2020, right? They say tomato. They pronounce T like T. They pronounce K like K, like cake. They don't say cake. In British you can say cake, but in American it is cake. So I love this difference very much, and I want to speak like American, especially when we talk about pronunciation, because pronunciation is also one of the most important aspects of language, right? So these are the three major differences between British English and American English. First one is spelling, second one is grammar, and third one is pronunciation difference.
Actually, sir, what is the best way to practice English?
The best way to practice English, if we talk about best way, so there are so many ways actually which you can follow to learn English language. But the best way is self-practice. My friends, what you need to do, like some people always try to find out the partner. So I don't have partner, nobody speaks English at my home. Means my parents don't speak English, my relatives don't speak English, my friends don't speak English. What do I do? So see, whatever practice you can do yourself, it can give you the best result, right? So practice yourself, like practice in front of mirror, practice in an empty room, audio recording, video recording. These are the best practices which can help you to improve your English language. So don't depend at others. Don't feel that, yeah, if I will find someone, then I will do practice. The best practice which you can do, the best practice which you can do is audio recording. Take your mobile phone, start speaking on any particular topic, and just save it and just listen to it. You can judge yourself, right? This because I have experienced in my learning process. I used to record my audio. I used to do this practice a lot, and it helped me a lot to improve my English language. So do audio recording, and I said like mirror practice, empty room. So these are the things which can help you to make your English fluent.
What is the most difficult thing about learning English?
Okay, there is nothing difficult in learning English language. The only difficult thing is your wrong way of learning English language. There are so many learners, they start learning English from wrong way. Now, what is the wrong way? They start learning from grammar. And I have seen so many classes, they start teaching grammar. They start teaching like present tense, past tense, future tense, just at the starting of their course. Right, so when you start learning grammar directly, you get confused, and then after you stop learning English language. That's why so many people believe that just by joining classes, we cannot speak English language. But in our SS English Academy, we have totally different way of learning. Right, we just make them perform different activities. We just teach them the basics of English. Right, so English, there is nothing difficult in English. Some people feel that grammar is very difficult. Grammar is also not difficult. If you learn it in a right way, right? So you can learn it easily. So there is nothing difficult. And some people try to learn any particular language in just one way. Like as I gave you example of grammar. Right, so some people just study grammar, and they have been studying grammar for last 6 months, 8 months, 10 months. They are doing nothing. So you need to follow different way of learning English language, right? If you are just following the one way, it is not going to help you. So follow different ways, do some activities, do conversation, do group discussion, and these are the things which can help you to make your English fluent.
Most of the thing which is very important in learning English. So if you have to choose one thing, so what would be that one thing?
Okay, as I said, there are so many things which can help you to learn English language. But if I have to choose one thing which is very important for every learner, that is self-belief. If you do not believe in yourself, you cannot do anything, right? If you do not have belief, even the easiest thing will be difficult for you. But if you believe in yourself, even the toughest thing will be easy for you. Right, so belief plays a very important role when you want to do something in your life, when you want to learn something in your life. You would have seen there are so many people, they start learning English language, after a couple of days, couple of months, they stop learning it. They join English speaking classes, after 1 month or after one or two months, they just stop learning, they stop going to classes. Why? Because their belief system is not strong. So you need to make your belief system strong if you want to learn anything. Because when you start learning something, you are going to face difficulties, problems. It is not going to be easy, right? Means problems will come, difficulties will come, you have to face it. You have to face challenges. And for facing challenges, you need your belief system should be very strong. So belief system is going to help you a lot to learn English language. So self-belief is very important for learning English language.
Can we learn English through English learning apps?
Okay, there are so many apps which can help you to learn English language. But I believe that apps are not going to help you to speak English language. It will just improve your knowledge. It will just improve your grammar skill. You see, I've seen many students. They have been using English app for last 5 months, 10 months, 1 year. But they are unable to speak. Their grammar is good now, but they are unable to speak English language. So no English app, English learning app can help you to speak English language. It will just give you knowledge about grammar. It will give you knowledge about some particular thing, but it will never help you to speak English fluently. For these, you need to do something practical. For example, if you are a hardware engineer, right? So you cannot learn hardware just by reading hardware books. If I will give you one book and I will tell you that after reading book, you need to go there and go at one particular place and you need to repair this computer. You're not going to repair it until you see it by some experts or until you do it yourself. Right? So practical is very important, and no learning application will teach you any practical thing, right? So English learning apps will just increase your English knowledge or grammar skill, but it will never help you to speak English fluently.
Last but not the least, tell our viewers that why should we start learning English now?
See, language is the blood of the soul into which thoughts run. So you use any particular language to express yourself, right? And if we talk about English, so it is one of the most important languages in the world. Right, so you should start learning English immediately, as early as possible. Because if you are wasting your time, then there are so many opportunities which you are going to miss in future. I have seen so many learners, when they get fail in interview, then they come and they join classes and they start learning English language. But you missed that opportunity which could have changed your life. Right? So start learning English from today only, because it is going to change your life. It is going to help you a lot in future, and it has endless benefits. Right? I'm sitting in front of you, I'm speaking in front of camera just because of English. For example, if I don't know English, I will not be able to speak, I will not be able to share my knowledge with you. So English is the language which can change your life. And I always say this sentence that English is a language which has changed my life. So if you want to change your life, you need to learn English, need to improve it. There are so many opportunities which can help you to change your life and which can make you a better person in life. Thank you very much.
I hope our learners love this advice.